So,
say goodbye. Hide your face from my eye.
Feels like it's gonna rain again. Yes, hello. I'm Dr. Reed from the Santa Margarita Institute.
I'm sorry, but Mr. Felton is no longer a patient.
I know. This is why I'm here. Hello? Anyone? Good evening.
Miss Reed, you already told me at the intercom, and as I already told you, Mr. Felton is no longer a patient at the Santa Margarita Institute.
I came here voluntarily, outside the Institute.
So what do you want?
I am personally re-examining your case. Causes, reagents. I strongly believe there are alternative ways and probably other experiments that are worth a try. I am fighting with the Institute to recognize there are other adequate remedies for your husband's pathology.
Oh, no, please. I'm just assisting him. I'm his nurse.
I didn't know.
It's okay. I suppose you want to talk to him.
Thank you.
I apologize for the darkness, but Mr. Felton's sight has been damaged and immensely compromised because of the disease. Anyway, I am Gloria. Oh, and please, refrain from smoking inside. Mr. Felton hates the smell of smoke.
Sorry.
Please, this way. bad habit.
Smoking?
Yes, such a shame. You should quit. You have no idea how bad this is for you. Not only for your health, but it's also very expensive. Money and time wasted. I have so much to do every day, I couldn't waste time with such a bad habit.
Do you assist Mr. Felton all day?
Oh no, from midday to 8 p.m. Then I go back home. I live near here. If needed, he can contact me with a pager, but that's not often. His wife takes care of him when I'm off.
What can you tell me about her?
I met her just a couple of times. She's usually out or locked in her bedroom when I'm here. Let's say they don't seem to get along.
I didn't know.
But, you know, when she's home, she listens to the same music. The same song. Over and over. This way, please. Mr. Felton will be here in a few minutes.
Okay.